in the road. Sunlight splashing on the hill, as if to say it always will. Only thing I want deep down, a cup of coffee and a quarter round. The quarter round is as fancy, but the cup of coffee definitely.
Stuff is starting to be there, and that's just, I don't know why it's like that, it just is like that. It's just, that's just the way it happens. That's one of the things that's real interesting. See, I have also in my life a kind of a slow solo career, you know, that is kind of like to keep my hand in and keep my chops up, and for my own, it's like scratching my own musical itches in a certain kind of way. And my band represents my concept of music more, you know, than the Grateful Dead does. And the thing that I realize about myself as a musician is that I'm a relatively conventional in my imagination is relatively conventional.
Thank you. Thank you.
ground, and everyone went rushing for the door. The
always found the West Coast based country style music possesses a more colorful sensibility that truly echoes its Nashville predecessors, in that, you know, like kind of like that Wild West kind of way. Appalachian folk style music was part of the West Coast stylings from very early on. And in this case, going back, you know, even a little further than, say, Graham Parsons, who mainly influenced the Southern California scene. Whereas Jerry Garcia, Dave Nelson, Frank Wakefield, and all those guys kind of brought Appalachian folk style music to the forefront of the more psychedelic experimental environment. Yeah.
Thank you. the moonbeam down so lightly on this distant field of clover. The gypsy cowboy wanders because he knows. So quiet, the town is down in slumber. It's cowboy lady murders. Let's roll another number. Trouble that's in this old world, it makes me so sad. Oh, oh, so sad. Mama an angel.